Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Drakensang the Dark Eye. Today's episode is going to focus around us getting in and talking to Count Growin. Now, you will notice that our save is in a slightly different place than last time. That is because I scoured for Duck and finally found his stupid dwarf ass. So, let's do this. This shouldn't be too terrible. And I apologize if I'm a bit slower on the draw today than usual, but I'm recording this very early in the morning and I just got up. But I got stuff to do today, so, and I want to get this up Tuesday, preferably Tuesday, maybe Wednesday, so yeah. Hey, Regent Lady, I think we worked with you earlier. We probably have to talk to her.
You're back. Were you able to find out anything?
We don't really care what she has to say. She's just wanting to know about, some stuff done in the harbor district. There's Growin. Hell, good dwarf.
Oh, the Shield of Fendral. A truly beautiful piece. May the wise Ascender be patient with my envy. But let's not dwell on that. First, we should fix the formalities. So tell us, how can Count Growin's humble resources serve you on this momentous day?
The Holy Oracle says my destination is Murilash, my Count. Master Aquarian was convinced that you would be able to help me. Oh-ho, convinced is he? That old bird is rarely wrong, my boy. But we have a little contract with Murilash at the moment. That doesn't sound good. What happened? If only I knew. Our beautiful dwarf quarter has been shut off by the rock crunchers. Not necessarily unusual in times of crisis, but these murders and trade disputes. But when our good Gerlin tried to ask the rock crunchers for an explanation, he was given an unusually gruff response. But that happens every now and then too if the rock cruncher leader is in a bad mood. In these times, Gerlin usually uses his good relationship with Murilash and demands written arbitration from the Mountain King Arambalash. But we haven't heard from Murilash for some time. My top diplomat fears that all is not well. That is why he's already set off to the small town of Talon. The little valley in which it lies was used for diplomatic meetings in times of crisis. But normal channels of communication could not be used. So if you want to go to Murilash, you should try to catch Gerlin in Talon. Thank you very much. I will set off for Talon immediately to meet with Gerlin. What else can I do for you? I have joyful news. I managed to track down Castan Gamblack in the Dark Forest. Unfortunately, he refused to be taken down to Firdock as prisoner. I was forced to slay him and his dragon cultists. A foolish man who deserves little more. You've earned your reward. Here, take the ducats, these garments bearing the arms of Firdock. Okay, so we got some ducats and... what else? Okay, some ducats. Ah, chainmail shirt of the city. We'll give that to Forgrim. Well, if it's better. 444. Ah, same difference. But at least it's...
let me do that.
More official armor. Okay. Well, it looks like we are on our way to Talon, and Gladys is probably stuck on a door back here or something. Yep. Gladys. You're not too smart. Before we do head out, I want to sell a bunch of crap, and then we shall go.
And our quest shall begin anew.
Only downside to this place is that it's right by that stupid obnoxious guard. So I'm sure we're going to be getting an earful of, oh dear, oh dear. My voice acting is just terrible. Alright, merchant. We're going to do some trading.
Welcome.
Yeah, okay. Get rid of that, get rid of that. Just get rid of this mace, too. Let's see for Amazon here. Pride. I know she's just got a bunch of crap on her. A trident. Keep that. Okay. And she, of course, has absolutely nothing of value on her. These go over with the rest of my crafting stuff. Okay. So now would be the time to head for the exit of town. I'm going to take the long way around because I don't want to listen to that stupid freaking guard. And those guys can just sit there and do their own thing. Crazy dwarves. And their infinite money generation schemes. Oh my god! The terror horse.
I can't hold on much longer.
Just go piss in a corner or something. Relief. Take some Ex-lax.
Can't desert my post. I can't hold on much longer.
Where the bushes are calling my name. Okay, where are we? Ah, Talon. Talon! Look at that little pawn move. Looks like it was a peaceful trip. Once we load in, I'm gonna save. After I get done yawning. I am not a morning person, and I am forced to be a morning person sometimes. It annoys me. Come on. Seriously now. Okay. Are we loading into a cutscene or something? I dare say we probably are. Or maybe not. Okay. Saving. Alright. So he is to the south. Alright, we could probably cut off the road.
200 divine cycles ago, my people saved Talon from a dragon. I'm curious to see whether the people there still remember that.
The time of the great scaled ones is long past. Fools like this Growin are all there is to hunt these days. It's a disgrace.
Sorry about that. Had to blow my nose. Got piggies and random chests. Gladys, do your lock pickery thing. Gladys, loot. God, of course it's crap. I don't really think we want any of that. How's this thing? No. Okay. I'm making a note of something here. There. Okay. Piggies! And Jargold the Swineherd. Hello, Jargold the Swineherd. You just keep on herding those swine. And what is this? A felled tree.
You there! Stop it once! In the name of Preus!
No god! At your service. How can I help you, m'lady? You know how to behave. What a stroke of luck in these disrespectful times. I'm the noblewoman Arkania. Of the mountain. As you may have noticed, I'm something of a plight, unfortunately. My coach had an accident when a wheel broke. The horses bolted. The dolt of a coachman already left hours ago to get help from Tal in the next town. But he still is not back. He's probably lying asleep somewhere by the roadside, or he's having a conversation with a drink in some tavern. Go and find this good-for-nothing for me so that I can continue my journey. Sure, I'll find your coachman. It is settled. Find the coachman and bring me news of him. I will see you again soon, hopefully. Yeah, if he's on the way.
A fallen tree and a missing coachman. If this isn't an ambush, I'll eat my hat.
So, Rulana, you could say that it's a trap! Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yep. What do we got? Goblins! Goblin Berserker! We will let them come to us. Run away! Okay, what do we got here? Okay, this shouldn't be too bad. Do that.
Listen
you,
up, everyone.
You get up in there, and I want to see how this works, actually.
For Rondra.
And sure, you need to buff, or you're gonna get pasted. Devon's got awesome points, so he should be okay. Okay. Yeah, this isn't too bad. Yeah, Devon's hitting pretty hard now with his new sword when he hits. Okay. Found a bad little ambush there, I guess. They don't really appear to have anything of particular value on them, though. A bloody hatchet. But we now know that there are goblins in the area, so we should probably keep an eye out. Oh, yeah. I think we're gonna come out here and kill this thing. Oh, and there's the coachman. Oh, no!
More new human. Die, too.
Of course it's not just one. It's never just one. What the hell kind of noise was that? Okay. Everyone get on that berserker again.
Good choice.
And you do your spinny doom attack. We have a kinda maybe sorta AoE in the form of Rulana dancing around with her sword. Alright, let's all just focus on them and bring them down here. Things aren't too beefy, but they go down quicker if we focus fire. Okay. What is that? Molodeshanaja. A swashbuckling weapon. Okay. 1d plus 4. How does that look with foregrim? 1d plus 5. But it doesn't have any penalties. What does it fall under? Axes and maces. I think we're actually going to have him use that instead of the other weapon, just because it doesn't penalize his attacks. Or defense, rather. Hey, we took that goblin's nuts! Badoosh! Coachman! Okay, just making sure. Oh no, take all that crap. God damn it. Okay, I suppose we'll go back and tell this woman that her coachman got pasted by goblins. Yeah, your dude's dead. He got stabbed in the face repeatedly. I have a feeling she's gonna be like, "Well, why don't you bring me a wheel then, you knave?" Which Devon would probably tell her to shove the wheel up her behind. Devon can hobnob, but he doesn't like the nobility.
My rescuer returns. I hope you bring good news.
Of a sort, I found your coachman. Unfortunately, I have to tell you that he's dead. Goblins slew him. How terrible. Warren, have mercy on his soul. I implore you. Please, Devon of Echelon, take me to Talon. I do not dare travel this dangerous region without accompaniment. I'm willing to pay you 20 ducats for an escort to Talon. Sure, why not? You won't be harmed. Thanks be to the 12. Now let us waste no time. We have to go now. Okay, how... Oh, at least she's got a decent amount of hit points on her. And I can heal if necessary. So I'm gonna have these two rebuff. And we're gonna save again. That way if anybody gets pasted, we won't have to run through this whole area all over again. I just hope she doesn't, like, rush into combat. Like, if she stays behind, I'm okay with that. Oh my god, you're serious? Another freaking ambush? No. Where's the freaking... Is that it? Just one berserker? Okay.
Listen up, everyone.
Blood, my sword.
Oh, you're good. Get away from her. No, you stupid woman. And Devon's like, I got this. Esper's like, okay. Oh, damn. Devon does got that. You tell him, Forgrim. Okay, we'll have her bandage herself. And while she does that, we will loot another one of those redonkulously named axes, which probably means something in German or something. If it means something in German, let me know, because that would probably be kind of cool. And I know, I think I missed one, but that's alright. Alright, and now that there are wild boar up here, this kind of worries me because I know that they are somewhat fond of inflicting wounds on people. Okay, the question then becomes, can I hit it from here? Of course not. Let's throw her bow down here again. And Uber Arrow, go! She's all like, I'm a ninja! Kadoosh! Hey, 11 damage, not bad. Get in there, guys. We'll let her get one more arrow off. Oh my god. This fight just got bad.
Avenging Kirkham.
Maybe. What are those? Ah, they're just normal goblins. Okay, maybe not too terrible. Kill the boar. Yeah, this probably won't be too terrible.
Drink blood, my sword.
I really should, here. Attack. You go back there and cause chaos in the ranks of the archers. While we handle these boars. Come on, guys, I'll get on one. And she's back there just kind of doing her thing. Yawning in the middle of battle, as she's apt to do. Wow, she's kicking those things' asses. Ooh, Lana. Holy crap. Wow, okay, they've only got a little bit of health. I was about to say, holy shit, she's just like wading through those things. And a bunch of pelt scraps. Awesome, awesome, awesome. But I will take them because that adds up slowly. What is wrong with her? Weapon poison. So what did you say? Is that, does that mean she's poison, or did she poison her weapon? And if she poisoned her weapon, so what'd she do, like, coat her fists in poison? Because if so, that's pretty freaking hardcore right there. Alright. Goblins, guys, holy crap, there's a mob of them down here. And yes, I know I'm saving more than usual, but we've got a stupid obnoxious wench to protect and...
Good choice.
I don't want her to get pasted. Since that's red, I'm gonna go ahead and assume that she's been poisoned, so we're gonna try and cure it. There we go. How long do they have? A minute and a half. Alright, nope.
Here we
you
go.
You two need to stop being stupid. That archer, it's like, I know what I'm doing. Oh, dang it. She's pretty beefy now that she's got her crazy armor and stuff. I assume you've only got like 20 hit points. You do. Yeah, you're getting some thunder magic here. Have a thunderbolt. It tastes like chicken! Gladys is almost dead, but I don't really care.
I'll take care of that.
Okay. No, wrong one. No, goddammit. There we go. Bandage. Healing magic. Go. Oh, and Devon's poisoned now. And so is she. We'll cure it off of Devon. And once again, I was writing something down. Keeping track of something. Don't worry about it, nothing important. Okay. Archer probably doesn't have anything worth anything, but yeah. Figure check anyways. Camera, why are you causing me trouble? Hey, I see civilization in the distance. What about the town's like under siege or on fire? Holy crap. What did they do? Light this horse on
fire? Stop there, please.
Yo. In the name of Perrin, what is that? Well, it looks like a horse that somebody lit on fire. This was surely the work of those detestable goblins. I couldn't bear contemplating that across my path. We should hurry on to town quickly now. I think we should leave her with the cooked horse. Probably tastes like, I don't know, whatever cooked horse tastes like. Oh my god. Oh, I see a shaman. See if I can actually target him. So, one. I just want to know, like, how much... I assume we're going to want to focus on the shaman first. To the exclusion of other things, but if it's got a boatload of hit points, I might focus on, where is he? There he is. 45. Well, first we're going to pop shield.
For Amazon Prime. For Rondra.
Okay. Oh, Devon, you are in trouble. Devon's like, I can tank this. Alright, I think Shaman is down. Where is that berserker? There is that berserker.
Listen up, everyone.
Alright.
Devon, why you have to miss with your awesome overhead chops? Ooh. Damn. Rulon and Foregrim are just messing things up. I'll be over there for you guys in just a minute. Must kill melee first. Man, those damage numbers just fly by. Okay, these guys aren't too tough, so we'll have Rulana get one while the rest of the group gets the other. Come on, Rulana, you got this. Yeah, these things only got the 22 health. Okay. It's Band-Aid time, holy crap. Gotta detox like 90% of the party here. And now we wait. Who's she getting? Foregrim? Yeah. Come on. I'm not even gonna bother looting the goblins except for the berserker and that shaman. Where is there he is. Fire Moss, Tosa, One Berry Juice, Ulgin Root Brew, and a club that he can hold on to. And we're gonna save. Things are getting somewhat heated, you could say. So is the town under siege? Or do they just have a slight goblin infestation? I mean, the goblins don't pose too much threat to such talented and brave adventurers as our party.
At last, but it looks closed. Follow me. As a reward for your help, I'll make sure they let you into Talon.
Well, that is a reward that is much nicer than the 20 ducats you were offering.
Halt! Talon is in a state of emergency. The terrible events of the past days have forced us to close the town gates.
Aww, I am the noblewoman in Ingania of the Mountain. Because she introduces herself as her full name, that's pretty bad. And these are my bodyguards. Mayor Dipwedge. Ooh, that's something out of Dwarf Fortress right there. He's a personal friend of our noble house. He will certainly be quite annoyed if he should hear that you had kept us waiting. Now finally, let us enter. Bodyguards? Noblewoman. Forgive me, noble lady, but it has become dangerous in the Tarnal Woods. You may pass.
We've made it. Thanks to your strong sword arm, we've arrived safely in the city. Your service has been invaluable. Here, take this sum as a small token of my gratitude.
Well, cool beans. Many thanks, milady. The money will be most useful. It was my pleasure. Farewell.
What are you still doing here?
Battering ram with the captain would really cause problems. Perhaps they'll let us in if we help repair the bridge.
You tell him, Forgrim. Now, when he says lout, I assume he was referring to the guardsman, but I'm just going to pretend he was referring to that noblewoman, because it's funnier that way. Okay, so it looks like we've got a little bit of civilization here, and I'm just, like, constantly impressed by how nice the zones in this game look.
What do you mean you don't have any tongue?
Don't even...
Sorry, but Gallo Frantric left me high and dry. He promised me the tongues, but when I went to get them, he didn't have any more.
By all the 12 gods, you just can't rely on anyone these days.
Whoa!
They call me Mother Sweeting. What can I do for you?
I just have a question for you. Have those wolves been bothering you? Let me see your wares.
Are those damn wolves in their incessant howling? An older woman can't get any sleep.
These axes are not worth nearly as much as I'd hoped they would be worth. The Ulgin Root Brew is the holy... Oh, that's the poison immunity. Don't care! Blood Leech in a jar! That's the best item! Salve of Healing. Ah, that's just a bonus to treat wounds. Wound Powder! Vitality Point Regeneration plus one. Yeah, sure, why not. Okay, I would really like to, like, start stockpiling healing items. But I don't know how feasible that's gonna be, because from what I gather, the end of this game is pretty darn rough. And they suggest you have a lot of healing items with you.
Fresh herbs, dried roots, everything your heart desires.
You sound very bored, m'lady. However, I would like to buy some of your herbs. Let me see what you have. Do you have any one berry juice? Of course you don't. You have one berries, though. Which I'm assuming that if I had alchemy, I'd be able to make into one berry juice. I do, however, want to buy some more goal moon leaves, because it would appear that poison is becoming somewhat common, so we are going to buy 16 of them. Interruption, even 30. There. What do you say?
Praise Nandus. Are you seeking assistance in matters of magic and arcane lore? Or is it ingredients you seek? Or do you perhaps desire to learn new spells?
What spells can you teach me, old man? Perhaps fireball? Okay. Aerofuge vacuum. Just creates vacuum in the form of a ball within all areas removed. Ooh, suffocation and run the risk of being stunned. So it's an AoE. Looks to be a damage over time. Spell cast time. Holy crap, that thing's got a cast time on it. Let's see what else he's got. Move as the lightning. And the move speed boost. Cold shock. Yeah. Ah, dang. We're gonna take that. Wait, summon Jin? Or Genie? Jin, however it's pronounced. Spell duration 20 minutes. Holy crap. Duplicitous double vision. Eclipsis shadow force. We get a shadow minion. So I wonder if we could have multiple and just like run around with a freaking army. Elemental minion. Thunderbolt. Master of animals. Horrifish phantasmus. There's what we're looking for. She creates a mighty fireball and hurls it. 5d6. Holy crap. And things catch fire. Yes. Ball of lightning. Paralysis. So there's some petrification magic right there. Which I don't think I'm gonna worry too much about. Skeletarius. Raise an undead assistant. Yeah. Sleep a thousand sheep. Pestilential breath. I love the spell names, they're just so ridiculous. This one's a fire elemental. We are going to pick up the summon djinn. Education of magic mage. I have no idea what that means, but we're learning it. We're also going to learn alchemy. Why, you ask? So that I can make potions later if I need to. However, first, we got some stuff to put points into. Fireball. You have no idea how tempting that cold spell was, just so I could make cold puns, but I'm okay. Holy crap, this thing has a long cast time. 5d6 plus SP damage. Okay, so I think that's 5d6 plus 10 then? Maybe? I hope. And we will crank some ranks into our summon as well. Okay. And his other stuff's all maxed. Alright, so we gotta adjust things here. Alright, I never use these, and I never use that, so we're gonna throw that there. Fastest a body can stay there, because if I move it, I'll forget where it is. Throw that there. Throw Healy Magic there. And summon Jin there. Okay. Gladys, maybe we can make you a little bit less useful. A little bit less useful, a little bit less useless, rather. Let's see here. Where's that cold snap? Cold shock. Learn. I'm also going to give her Balm of Healing. Okay. She's only got 36 by comparison. Okay. What does she have? Light, Lightning Find You, and Fandango Fireflies. Well, now you've got Fireball but Cold Damage, so I can get those puns in. Balm of Healing. And we will keep Lightning Find You down there just for the debuffs. Okay. Bump this up to level 10. Bump this up to, I think, 9, because it's on multiples of 3, I believe. Yeah. Okay. And, let's see. Damage spell. So that's just 10 damage, then. So I'm gonna bump that up to 11. We're gonna want that to be as high as possible. And, let's see here. I'd say she's probably okay. Arcane Lore doesn't do anything for extra spells, does it? No. I just realized we are, like, way over 30 minutes, but that's okay. I'm excitable and happy that we're actually getting some stuff here. Eh, I don't really need upper sneak. I'd say she's okay there. Okay. I want to save, because I actually want to. I want to see how these spells targeting things work. Here. See, that it doesn't give me, like, an area of effect worries me, because this is a game that I would expect has, friendly fire. But, we are at about 36 minutes, so I think I'm gonna call an episode here. As per usual, folks, thanks for watching, and I hope to see you all next time in Let's Play the Dark Eye Drakensang.